Welcome to Excel Table Talk, our monthly web show for our community. My name is Blake Walsh, and I'm a PM on the Excel team. Before we get started, I'd like to plug our community at office.com/excel/community, where you can go create an account if you haven't already. In there, you'll find a bunch of spaces where you can have discussions, ask questions, and the like. My peers and I are in there quite a lot, so this is also a great opportunity to interact with us, learn tips and tricks, and influence the future direction of the product. You'll also find that's where we keep our blog, where we post regular updates as to the latest and greatest. So please be sure to check it out and come back regularly for updates. All right, now for our main topic. I have here with me Steve, and he's here to talk about Excel for Mac. I hear there's a lot of great new stuff with the new release this year. Can you tell us a bit about that?
Yeah, I'd be happy to do that. We did have a major release of Excel for Mac, as well as Word and PowerPoint for Mac in January, and we have a lot of great new features. And I just want to get right to it. So the first one we have is the ability for multiple people to work in a document at the same time, or what we call co-authoring. So co-authoring is fantastic. In the past, if you had a document open and then somebody else wanted to work in there, then they open it up, they would get a nasty message saying this file is locked by somebody else. So you could just open it up and read it, but you couldn't do any work in there. And now we break through those barriers, and now multiple people can work in here at the same time. So what I'm showing on my screen is a workbook where I have it open in Excel for Mac, and I also have it open in Excel online just to show that I can work in the same document in two places. And I've also sent you a link to it.
So yeah, I saw that.
Go on your phone, then you can join in as well.
Yeah, let me open that up.
So while you're doing that, I'm just going to go and make some changes. And the people watching, you can notice that as soon as I change Tim's name to mine for this one assignment, then over on the other side, The change is reflected as well.
You can now see it in the document.
Blake just joined us. So now I can see up in the top, we have this sharing corner. And as people come and work in the document with you, you can see a little icon that has their initials on it. And then if you click there, you can see their name and where they're editing. And then we also have a chat feature in there as well. So now this really enables people to get a lot more work done. There's not going to be any interruptions with the file being locked and things like that.
Very cool. And you can see on both screens here that, you know, I added that word to that cell there. Cool.
So that's nice, but I really don't like your change, so I'm just going to delete that.
Well, that's quite all right.
The next thing I'm going to show is really great. For several years, people have been asking for the ability to speed up our calculations by introducing what we call multi-threaded calculation. So for all you technical people out there, that's important to know what it is. But for most people, it's just a performance improvement that we have in Excel for Mac. So what I'm going to show here is a workbook that has over 100,000 formulas in it. And I'll push a button to start calculation. And at the start, we're working in the old method, which is single-threaded calculation, where all the formulas had to be calculated kind of one after the other. And then it's going to switch over midway through and do multi-threaded, which is where we do simultaneous calculations of formulas, and you'll see the difference in speed. So you can see the results here. I have the first with single-threaded calculation, they were taking just under a second. And then once we switched on the multi-threaded, they were taking about half that amount of time, and you can see the results of my test charted here.
Very cool. I mean, this is a huge improvement, but suppose I don't know exactly what this means. Do my complicated workbooks that I have built, do they just get better now, or how does this work?
They get better. You don't have to do anything. You don't have to know anything. The calculations just happen faster.
Excellent. That's great news.
Yep. It is great. And we know that our Excel fans have been asking for this for quite a long time, so we're extremely happy that we can offer it now. So we also have a whole set of new charts. So we have new chart types to enable you to visualize your data in much more powerful ways than we could in the past. So the first one we have is called the waterfall chart. So this waterfall chart is great for showing the revenue coming in and expenses going out for a business. So here you can see the blue column shows us all the revenue that came in, and then we can see the orange where the decreases happen. So these are costs going out, and then the gray bars show us the totals. So it's a really nice way to visualize your entire budget. We have two different charts that help you look at hierarchies of data. So this first one is called a tree map. So what we see here is a list of sales for the bookstore. And by looking at the tree map, we can see categories of books. And then within those categories, we can see smaller categories, which are kind of subcategories of the type of book. So you get a feel for which types of books are selling the most in the store, and then you can drill down and look at the subcategories as well. A similar idea is called the sunburst chart. Again, it's a hierarchical view of the data. So we can see the major categories on the inside rings, and then as we work our way out, we get to the more granular categories within the data. We also have a new histogram chart. So in this case, we see the price range of books represented as a distribution on this chart. So we can see most of the books fall into the center categories here, but you can also see the outliers that you have where you have higher priced books and lower priced books. And now to my favorite of the new charts. We now have 2D map charts in Excel, and these are really professional looking, much like you would see in a publication like the Wall Street Journal. And actually the example I have here takes data from the Wall Street Journal, but we're actually presenting a map that is coming right in Excel. So I have oil price reductions here that have happened over a recent period of time. And it's broken down throughout the world, but I can easily zoom in on an individual continent if I'd like to. So here I can switch. I was looking at Africa. Now I can zoom in and look at Asia, or perhaps I want to switch over to North America. And the chart just immediately adapts to the selected data that I have. And it's just a very professional looking chart and beautiful to look at.
I feel like I've definitely built something like this manually, and it took quite a lot of time. Where are the, you know, how does Excel know where, you know, a country starts and stops?
Well, I'd be surprised if you built this manually, but the map charts work with data coming from Bing. Bing, as we know, has a strong map engine, and the maps are downloaded into Excel, and then we basically show you the same exact experience that you would get in Bing Maps.
That's amazing, and it only takes a few seconds.
It does, yes. Another few really nice handy features. One is what we call slicers for tables. So for a long time, we've had what we call slicers, which are basically easy to use buttons to filter your data. We've had those on Windows Excel for quite a while, and now we have those on Mac as well. So in this case, I have a table of all the products in the business. And if I'm interested in perhaps just looking at the products that fall into the economy class, and maybe from just one of my sub-businesses, like Contoso, I can just click on the slicer, and it will filter my table down there. And now if I want to see even deeper, so here I just have the blue items from Contoso. It's just a simple way to filter your list. These are really great when you want to provide an easy way for others to use a workbook. So you can set up the data you want, you set up the slicers, and it's just a matter of pushing buttons for them to get to the data that they're interested in.
Right, and so with the power of CoAuth here as well, I mean, if I've never even used Excel, you can share this file with me and I can just come in and click the buttons that you've built for me and not need to know anything more. I can then just get the views that I'm looking for.
That's right. There's no need to know anything about filtering. You just click a button and it's very self-explanatory how this works. Another really important feature that we've added is what we call pivot charts. So for a long time, we've had pivot tables on Mac Excel, but we haven't had the ability for pivot charts, which have also been on Windows Excel. Now we've added the power of pivot charts. And really the important thing to note is just that the chart will adapt immediately when you make changes to your pivot table that it's associated with. So here I have a simple pivot table with some sales data from my company, and I have slicers that we just talked about. And you can see the chart. So we're just seeing the sales by product category and type. And I can just simply click on a category. I clicked on computers to take that out of my pivot table as one of my product categories. And if you notice, the chart updated as I did that. So I can add that back in, and you can see that the chart updates. It's almost too fast to notice. It seems simple, but it's actually a very powerful feature that we haven't had there before on Mac. And that brings me to the next feature, which is what we call a timeline. So this data has a date component to it, so we know when the sales occurred. And on my chart right now, I'm showing data from the four quarters of 2017. And if I wanted to expand that out and show all of 2016 as well, I simply drag along the timeline, and you can see the filter shows me which quarters are included in my data. And again, the pivot chart was updated as I did that. Now, if I want to focus in just on 2016, I can drag the other end of the timeline, and I took away 2017 data, and now I'm just focusing on 2016.
Very cool. Was there anything special you need to do to your data to make it show the timeline with the quarters, and you know what goes into that?
You don't need to do much. As long as your data contains a field with dates, you can insert a timeline. It's simply on the insert menu, you can just insert timeline, and then Excel will know which field has a date in it, and it will only allow you to pick those fields.
Gotcha. And so in this case here, I mean, because you had dates, Excel knew how to bucketize it by quarter, right?
That's right. In this case, when I add a date field to my pivot table, Excel will automatically do some date grouping for me, so I can choose to either show by year, by quarter, or by month, and then even down just to the individual date if I wanted to.
Nice.
There are some additional smaller things that we've done to make the Excel for Mac a little bit more like the Excel for Windows, and we're going to continue to improve the experience and continue to make Mac Excel the best it can be.
Thanks, Steve. This is really great stuff. Very cool to see how we're listening to our community and, you know, really leveraging, you know, their what they want to see in the product to make it better so they can be more productive. So one thing I like to ask people is, you know, what's your favorite Excel feature, tip, or trick, you know, that we can share with our audience?
The one I'd like to share is that you can send feedback to us. So we love to listen to our customers, and you can simply click on the little smiley face button that you find in the upper right corner of your screen, and you can tell us what you like. We love to hear smiles about what you love about Excel, but you can also tell us what we can do better. You simply click on there, and then you can write to us and tell us what issues you're having, what problems you're encountering, or requests that you have for new features, and then send that in to us, and we really love to see all that. And we do look at it. And if you want to get a response from us, you can include your email address. And while I can't guarantee that we'll respond to you, there are many cases when we send a response to you, and then we can get in a dialogue and get more information to work on the issue.
That's great. Thanks so much for sharing that, Steve. It really just kind of goes to show how much we listen to our community and how, you know, we want them to help us, you know, help them be more productive in Excel, build a better product. And another big part of our community efforts, you know, involves the MVPs. And you'll find them quite often answering questions, you know, oftentimes faster than we can get to them in the community. So they're, you know, they're super helpful. We really appreciate everything that they do. And when they were in town recently, we actually had an opportunity to catch up with some of the MVPs.
You have to watch other people use Excel. Really, I mean, it just, there should be a job where you just watch someone else use Excel.
Find a forum, start asking questions, and start answering questions.
If you can't work it out on your own, hit the forums and ask questions.
Believe me, if it wasn't for that, I wouldn't be standing here today. Forums are gold mines.
Explore the new tools that are in Excel.
Explore the commands that you see on the ribbon.
There are things that will probably solve your problems of what you're trying to do in a better, quicker way. And you just gotta be willing to put in that time to find those out.
First time I actually used Excel was when I went to take your kid to work day. My dad hauled me out and made me key punch his data entry for the day into the software. So lots of fun.
I was a one-day temp at a yo-yo company in Southern California. Just showed up 6 hours, just entered data into sales.
I was 12. And I had to create a presentation for a class. And so I used Excel, I used the charts, and then I made a really cool chart. The visualization principles I used, I would not use now, but you know, sixth grade.
20 years back.
Oh, the first time I used Excel was back in college, right? And we were actually using Excel for classwork.
Oh, I remember it so clearly. I was a management accountant in London, and I was sat down in front of this massive spreadsheet, and I didn't know what I was doing, but I just loved it straight away. It seemed so much power.
I've created a few spreadsheets where people said, hey, this is Excel.
The coolest spreadsheets I've ever come across are at the E90, E50, FX. It's a team of Hungarian Excel developers, and they do really awesome Excel charts, and I've gotten a lot of inspiration from that. And really, stuff that may seem wacky, but has a lot of learning behind it.
There's this guy in Japan, and he does paintings in Excel in tiny little cells, and they come out. They look incredible. I wouldn't have ever thought to use Excel to create art. Yeah, people do it.
A musician put all of the scales and modes into Excel and had a diagram of piano keys showing, you know, if you've got A flat, C, and F, what scales and modes does that fit in? That was pretty neat.
There was a lady in Kentucky, like in the mountains of Kentucky, who was using Excel to design her quilts. And she hired me to write some VBA. She would put numbers in and then you would press a button and the colors would come in based on the numbers. It was crazy. I use Excel for numbers, but here was someone who was actually doing design work in Excel. It was wild.
Someone made a program in Excel about this Sudoku that somebody, so just clicking a button so I can have the Sudoku, one can solve the Sudoku, one can find the answer to the Sudoku. So I thought, oh my God, Sudoku, and that we can do in Excel.
Just as a reminder, our community is at office.com/excel/community. You can go in there, have discussions about these features, you know, interact with us and talk to us. That's all we have for now. So till next month, thanks for joining us.
Thanks for having me, Blake. This was great.
Yeah.